Hello, my darlings. Well, it's still Saturday. It's almost 6:30. We have literally just finished Emily St. John Mandel, Station 11. And I have some time. I also have a bonbon. Haven't I, Monty? He's such a good boy. We have some bad weather coming our way, and he always feels very sensitive to that, don't you? You always get fussy. He doesn't like thunderstorms. He doesn't like anything that represents bad weather, thunderbolts, anything that falls out of the sky. I guess that's because he had such a rough time when he was on the streets. But I'm here now, aren't I, darling? I'm here now. Mummy's here to take care of the Bonty. Yeah, he's such a good lad. He's purring like mad at the moment. You can't hear it, but I wish you could. He's such a good boy, aren't you? Hey, Monty the baby. Always wants my attention whenever I'm getting ready to sit down and do a quick video. But here we are. Saturday, I haven't done dinner yet, but I will be doing it soon. Have we having anything exciting? A Cornish pasty and some brown sauce, which is all I really fancy, and whatever it is that my eldest daughter wants, because the first once she's got the night off work, with it being her birthday weekend. And we have taken her shopping today. We've been out for street food, Korean food. Very nice. Really, really lovely.
Yes, they love it, don't they?
I know we do. Goodbye. He's busy sat down there watching me while I do a video. So yes, we've had a day of spoiling our eldest child, our eldest daughter, and giving her lots and lots of lovely things and lovely presents and taking her out shopping and buying her favourite foods. And tonight I'll make her something really yummy for dinner. And then we're all going to just relax, watch a bit of television, probably have an early night because tomorrow night is Spain versus England to finish off a beautiful weekend. And I'm so looking forward to just sitting down and watching the match. During the day, I will go and see my own mum because it's her birthday and she happens to be quite a good age, I won't say, because a lady never does. And it's her birthday as well. What else do I have to go to the pet store tomorrow? And we have to make a birthday cake, which I'm really looking forward to doing. Oh, and we're going to have a roast beef dinner with a really nice Italian red wine, of which the name escapes me right now. But yes, so that's going to be our weekend. A nice football match, nice food, relaxing time, baking a cake, going to the pet store, taking care of clients, because I do that pretty much every day. There's a why in it. I will do something. Have quite the busy life. It's what I choose to do. The best benefit for others, really. It's never easy, but we do it, and we do it with style and panache, shall we say. Gosh, whoever said working for yourself was easy was fibbing. It's never easy. I do to the side of preparedness, and the challenges that come with it are fabulous. They truly, truly are. And quirky. And not what at all what you would think. Which makes it even more Unbelievable. It really does. But yes, so that's what I will be doing tomorrow. Watching the football match of England versus Spain. Cuddling Monty. Cheering the team on. Making a cake. Sorting out birthday cards. Seeing to clients. Getting to the pet store. Joy. Yes, it's called finding joy in the everyday things. All the while that menopause is kicking my backside. I've had some terrible pains today in my back and my knees and my fingers. Oh, makes you wonder how we'll cope in the aftertime. Maybe 50 years old is literally all we can hope for, and that will be considered old age in the future times. Will we really be enacting Logan's Run? Who knows? Yes, reach the age of 30 and you get a change in the badge. It changes colour. So we all know that you're about to expire. Yes, and do you come back? Do you, heck? This is your one-time ticket to one-time fun times. Yeah, and once you're gone, you're gone. That's why you should appreciate everything while you're here. Eat that cake, drink that wine, have that movie, date that girl, date that boy. Adopt that kitten. Yes, adopt Monty's. Everyone should adopt a Monty. Absolutely. Because without them, the world would be a sadder place, wouldn't it? Wouldn't it be a sad place without the Mont-Bont in our lives? What are you doing? Oh, you want me to move the computer? Is that so you can get round? Hey? You're not going to chew it, are you? Oh, going in through a phase of Monty wanting to chew everything, don't you? Yes, I can see you. I can see. No, you don't. You don't chew my computer. Oh, such a so-and-so. This computer cost it near enough a grand, sunshine. You are not going to chew it. I don't know. It's an absolute menace. It truly is. But I love him. But yeah, so the menopause today. The menopause on me has not been agreeing. I have been indubitably naffed off by it. Yes, hot flushes, hot sweats, even though I'm wearing a jumper now because it's gone completely freezing. I don't want to put the heating on in the middle of July because that would be redonkulous, and we are not going to do that. As you can tell by my tired little eyes, I have truly seen it, done it, and now I wish to go and have a hot cup of tea. But before I go, I just wanted to let you know what we were up to this weekend. From the musings of the menopausal maiden. I may be losing my youth, but what I am losing in youth, I am gaining in wisdom. Ah, the trade-off. If I could have kept my beautiful body and had this wonderful, beautiful mind when I was 20, I wonder what life's choices I would have made. Possibly still have my two darling daughters. Yes, that goes without saying. Would I have married the same guy? Absolutely. And would have I adopted Mont-Bont? In a heartbeat. I definitely would have done. Wouldn't I, darling? Where's my little boy? What's he doing sitting on my printer? He'll either sit behind and fall asleep behind me while I'm talking to people, or he will bounce and pounce over everything I own. Yes. You are truly a nuisance. Nothing is safe from Monty. He is into everything. Aren't you? Aren't you? What have I got in here? Is this? That Monty's What's that?
Your bow. Monty's bow.
It's gone for it.
Yeah, I've run off with it.
Of course he has. So I wish you all a marvellous weekend. If I can get back to you tomorrow, I will try. If I don't, it will be whilst we're watching the football. I can promise you that. Or it'll be very first thing in the morning. I don't know. Depends what life throws at us. Will we all be here in the morning? Or will an asteroid hit overnight? Will the New Madrid splinter and fracture and cause a ginormous tsunami to go all the way from the Azores in Portugal and hit the coastal shores of Britain? Who knows? We shall have to wait and see. And until that time arrives when I can talk to you again, my darlings, have a wonderful evening, read fantastic books, and have the most wonderful time. Take care, my darlings. I will see you later.